How are we doing there, folks? Yeah, sorry about last week. The vlog didn't get done because I had a quite bad flu. So I didn't really feel like going out too much, you know. So, but today I've come out to do a short video about, you know, in my productions, all my exploring videos, why do I wear the German Army gear? In November 2015, I started doing more sort of direct vlogging explores, influenced by sort of exploring with Josh and Casey Neistat and all that stuff, you know, because those videos are really sort of, I don't know, positive videos, and I try and make my videos like that. I don't want the negativity with my videos. And yeah, in the November area I started doing the vlogging sort of videos, and I was wearing overalls, blue and yellow overalls, with a German coat on the top. But that sort of progressed, as you can see now with the latest videos. I've sort of got full German Army gear. You know, it's nothing political, it's just something like, I wanted to give my videos a uniqueness and make them stand out from the rest, which it has. It's just, I want to be different. All that army gear is surplus. Surplus German army. A lot of it dates probably from the 1980s, 1970s. I bought a German army naval hat the other day, and that was 1977. Also with the German gear, is it's lightweight, it's nice to wear, it's like a cotton material, it's really sort of soft. Yeah, it's very nice to wear, and it's really, really tough. You know, I wouldn't mind rolling about, going into places and getting those stuff ripped. I've ripped my trousers on barbed wire fence once, big deal, get it sewn up. But if I was wearing a pair of jeans or something like that, it's a different story. Because they're more expensive stuff. All the German, any surplus gear really, it's pretty cheap to buy. So, yeah. Hope you understand that, folks. If that comes across okay. Look at that building there. That's the officers' mess of the Citadel. This camera's heavy. I'm using a different camera today, folks. Let me know what you think of the quality. It's the Canon 70D, and it's got the Rode VideoMic on top of it. Rode VideoMic Pro. So, yeah, it's a tripod as well I'm holding. And it really does your arm in, actually. Christ. So, yes, talking about the the German Army gear. A lot of people have said sort of like things like stolen valor. I've never heard that before. I only just started hearing it about when people start commenting on my videos saying, oh, I'm doing it, stolen valor. Okay, I don't go around saying I'm a German soldier, for one thing. Don't wear medals, saying I fought in the battles. Okay, one of my jackets, surplus jackets, that was bought for £1 at the War and Peace show, has got rank markings on it, but I don't go around saying I own the rank, you know what I mean? I don't know where these people are getting these ideas from. But if we look back, say, look at these reenactments, War and Peace show that I went to. Got some footage coming up of that, might be interested in. There's people going around with medals on, Knight's Crosses, if you're looking at the German stuff. They didn't get rewarded their medals. It's what they're doing, they're reenacting it. But I'm not reenacting, but they are. Is that stolen valour? People going around with all these medals on. Do you know what I mean? Don't really understand it, folks. But yeah. The army gear that I wear in my videos is for the effects of the video. So when you see a thumbnail of one of my videos and it's got a German army flag on the shoulder of my arm, you know it's going to be a good video, this. I'm going to check this guy out. So yeah, I wanted to make my videos well, very unique to the YouTube community. I don't want to be just the same. What do you want me to go around in a hoodie? Whenever I get a comment about why am I wearing the German Army gear, I'm going to post this video to them, and that's it. I don't get into arguments about it, so I let other people do it. And also I'd like to say a big thanks for a lot of my fans actually who've backed me up and sort of said things to people and sort of tried to put them straight about why I'm wearing the gear. Thank you very much. So, oh dear, it's getting hot now, it's cold when I come out. What about a shout out to, there's a great channel, Second World War channel, called World War 2 History Hunter. This guy does metal detecting and also explores World War 2 bunkers. So please go check the link out above here, excuse me, and check his channel out. It's a very, very good channel, exploring channel, just like mine. So yeah, be sure to check that out, folks. Okay, what we got next? Right, in July, I went to the, cool, that's a bit bright. I went to the War and Peace show. It's a massive reenactment of World War II. And I've done some filming there. I didn't put it up in the, so I was gonna do a vlog just for that, but I didn't do it in the end. So I'm gonna do give you some clips of this War and Peace show. And yeah, hope you enjoy it. This is basically, it's a reenactment show. We've got tanks there, reenactors walking around, and stuff like that. So check this video out, folks, and I'll see you next week. Cheers.
How are we doing, folks? On the way to the War and Peace show. It's one of my vlog videos. This is not an exploring video as such, it's just a vlog video. So basically we're gonna have a look around this thing, see what's going on. I'm not gonna be filming no events. I'm gonna film bits and bobs, like tanks and stuff like that, and throughout the day, see what's happening. So the stalls, the guns, quite interested in all that. So we'll check all that out.
Could you survive that?
We're there, folks. War and Peace show. The sound of that. Brilliant. Getting hot now, folks. I think the best thing about the old War and Peace is actually the stalls. There's so much here. Everything you want, war stuff. Here we go, close for you, lad. Got the homebrew here, folks, drinking that up. Got to do it at these events. Too much. The beer prices in these places are very dear. Landmines, folks. It's crazy, isn't it?
This sort of size.
Really?
Yeah.
On
there,
aren't you?
Yeah.
Also. Show.
Someone doing the film business must have bought all that lot. Do you work at, what do you reckon, Colin?
Yeah, probably. It's probably not really a home. I mean, I'm gonna
what that in your garden? Oh, yeah. Put it in your garden, folks. So. Christ, it's madness. There's so much here. It's too much to take in.
Well, this thing here, this is made out of wool. How could you wear that thing on your face? That would itch like hell.
Not a lot.
Yeah, just a bit.
Okay, now I'm going to get
that. A lot of gear in there, look. How are you? All £5, folks. What is that, mate?
I think it's a flag.
What is it, Jamaican?
No. It's homemade.
One from the boar.
I've got hobnail boots on, folks, and on tarmac, it gets a bit slippery, if you know what I mean. And I'm on the rubber at the moment, so things are quite good.
And here we go, tarmac. That thing. They're fake though, aren't they?
Well, I couldn't see it flying.
This part of the War and Peace show is the part where it's all sort of shops and little things like that.
It's the home front area.
The home front area, this guy says. So basically shops and all that sort of stuff. It makes it look like it's the old fashioned times. Let's check this out.
Like being tied to it, sort of like horror film.
Yeah. Mental, isn't it, that?
Well, it certainly seems that the War and Peace show is over for another year, folks.
See you next year.
Yeah.
Just asking, does anybody remember where the car is?
No.
Nope. We don't know where the car is, Chris. Could be anywhere. Thanks very much for your support. And I'll certainly see you Friday for the exploring videos. I'll see you soon. Thanks very much, folks. This is the open reservoir. This is absolutely amazing. I've been to an underground Victorian one before. I'll try and redo that one again, but I've never been to an open one before, and there's a ladder over there. I'll try and get down this thing, folks.
Feeling a little exposed here.
Pretty.
Yeah. And then do the other one.
What's the other one connected to, though?
It probably does the rest of it.
There you go.
What the hell?
Oh, I'm not touching anymore, mate. My heart's going already.
Nah, these have all been cut open. It's just here.
Look, the whole place is alight.